Hey guys, so we're at Kalamegdan Park. This is Peja.
Hello.
Make sure to check out his Instagram because we're shooting absolutely phenomenal sunset pictures, actually snow pictures, and he's a really good photographer and he's going to China. The link for his Instagram is down in the description below and we're going to continue shooting because I cannot feel my hand anymore.
Same. Bye.
Hello from Belgrade. My name is Ivana and I am actually in my birth city through the organization To Glimpse. This organization makes exchange possible for adults. If you want to know more about them, the link is down in the description below. But here's mine and Auntie Lola's review of this week. I loved the sunset at Kalamegdan so much that I took Auntie Lola with me. So actually now I'm showing her Belgrade. Today was supposed to be the last day of me staying with her.
Isteklo je vreme našeg druženja zajedničkog. Nije isteklo vreme za Ivanu. Bilo mi je interesantno i zabavno i jako prijatno i sa vama i sa njom i nadam se da ćemo se opet videti.
Pa tako nam je bilo fino da smo odlučile oba dve da ja ostanem tu.
Jasno.
Dok mi roditelji ne dođe.
Da, da so. Ostane za uvek tu.
A ne za...
To ćemo drugi put.
So I told her that I was actually literally today on Friday I was supposed to move to another apartment where my parents are also going to be staying next week. And she was like, no, you're not leaving. And I was like, what? She was like, no, you're not leaving. Why are you going to be in that apartment when you can stay in my place? And I was like, yeah, why am I going to be alone in that apartment when I truly, truly enjoy spending time with her?
Da.
And she's such a good cook.
Baš dobro kuvaš. To ne bi svi rekli.
Pa nema veze, ja kažem. So actually, I really, really, really love this experience. I think Auntie did too. In case you don't know, I was invited by To Glimpse to review their experience. And I chose to go to Serbia and see it from a local perspective because I'm born here, but I never actually lived here. I can honestly say this was an eye-opening experience for me because I totally saw Belgrade from a different perspective than just being here on a holiday. And I can 100% recommend you to take a look at the To Glimpse website. There are many people from around the world who are either willing to host you or who you can invite to host in your home and show them your culture and your daily life. Because honestly, when I'm traveling, that's something that I enjoy, you know, learning about the most, like normal daily life. Because for some people, it's well, I think it's time to wrap this up. Obviously, I'm going to be vlogging more here in Serbia. I'm staying here until the new year. But yeah, I'm going to be with Auntie Lola. So you're going to be seeing her more. I wasn't even supposed to stay here for this long. I was only supposed to stay for like 4 or 5 days. But we loved it so much. And I can imagine that you're like, but how? It can be a scary experience to just get in touch with somebody who you've never met. And you know, I can imagine you want some tips about that. So here are my top 3 tips on how to make this a great experience. My number one tip: never forget that you're a guest in somebody's home. Being a good guest includes cleaning up after yourself, helping your host with whatever they need, and it actually includes something that you may not immediately think about: adjusting to their schedule. So if they go to bed early, you might also want to consider going to bed at the same time, because probably the next day they're also going to wake up at a certain time. And if you go to bed super late and then sleep in and your host, you know, has to wait for you a long time, that's not really being a good guest. The other way around, you know, if your host goes to bed way later than you're usually used to, you might want to adjust to that as well. But this is also where you kind of have to draw the line, because it shouldn't hurt you either. So for instance, I am an absolute baby when it comes to sleeping times. I need to get my 8 hours of sleep, otherwise the next day I am super grumpy. So when I was staying, for instance, with friends who go to bed way late, I would stay up with them for like the first 2 days, and then the third day I would say like, you know what, I really need my sleep tonight, and then go to bed on time. So try to find a middle ground there, but do try to adjust. For instance, I'm also a vegetarian, So I would never eat meat to make someone else happy, even if I am a guest. But I would tell somebody in advance that I am a vegetarian so they can take that into account. And even if they don't have anything at home, I will make sure that, you know, I take care of my own food, that they don't have to worry about that or feel bad. If I didn't mention that I'm vegetarian, I do not expect them to take that into account. Tip number two is bring your culture to the table as well. If somebody is open for this exchange experience and excited to talk about their culture, the chances are they're also very open to hear about your culture as well. So don't forget that. The easiest things to do are maybe your traditional meal from your home country. I can't cook Indian food here, but something else that you can do is bring them a gift. So I definitely did search for something to bring for Auntie Yolya. I'm going to serve Auntie Yolya an Indian experience. Dun 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 dun. You може?
Може.
Okay. Oh, samo jedno, samo jedno.
Sme?
Може?
Ovo
nije lepo.
No, nije. Eto pljuna.
Ja, može ako...
Ne, ne jede više.
Ne. A znači, to je digestive. Znači, ako se prejedeš, onda uzmeš ovu tabletu i onda to pomaže
sa...
Ne.
To je sigurno.
Ne. Ili to sve lakše ide?
Aha, kao probiotik.
Kao tako, da.
Ali ovo grozno je.
Možda imam nešto drugo Indije što se sviđa.
Je li ukusno?
To nešto drugo.
Šta je to?
Što sam ponela.
Jao, što je lepo. Jao, što su divne boje. Kako je to lepo, dobro da se sviđa. Da,
znači, divno. Ovo je prava pašmina iz Kašmir.
Kašmir, da.
Znači, Kašmir je jedan state u Indiji, gdje oni su poznati da to pravi.
Da, da, da.
Našla sam to.
Zna, vidjela sam da piše, to je dobar materijal.
Da, da.
Kašmir.
As you may know, India is an extremely colorful country, and one of my favorite combinations ever is the blue and pink. So that's why I thought blue and pink. And something that Auntie Yolya can wear every day here, because if I would have bought like an Indian dress or something, like she can't really wear that over here. And this is something she can wear every single day. And it's really something personal because I do love the pink and blue combination. Yeah. And of course, something else that you can do that's very easy to do if you have an internet connection is to let people listen to your traditional music. I love letting people listen to, you know, either Bollywood music if I'm outside of India, or letting them listen to Dutch music. For me, it's also super interesting to hear their reactions to that kind of music, which they've probably never heard before. The third tip might be the most important one, to be honest. Refrain from any judging when you're a guest in somebody's home. Again, this is kind of like being a good guest, but it's also part of travel. You don't have to live their life. So even if you don't like it at all, you can just respect it for a couple of days and try to adjust to just out of curiosity. You shouldn't do things that, you know, hurt yourself. Like, for instance, I wouldn't eat meat. But if I have to give you an example, Auntie Yolya is pretty religious. She goes to the church every single day, and I'm kind of fascinated with that because I don't have a traditional religion. My religion is love. So out of curiosity, even though I'm not, you know, Orthodox religious, on Sveti Nikola Slava, I did decide to go to church with her, just to see what it's like, because it's a huge part of her life. And I have to admit, it was very interesting to see. Like the churches, for instance, the Orthodox churches, they don't have benches, people stand. And I asked her, like, why is that? Why don't people just have benches to sit down? And she was like, well, it's out of respect. Like when you respect something, you stand up. And I was like, oh wow, that's like something new I learned. Just remember that. Also, I would never recommend you to have any discussions about religion or politics, like in depth. It's like such touchy subjects for people. I rarely get into those, but I don't enjoy discussing those in general. If you do enjoy those and your host enjoys those as well, then you might want to give it a try, but I would never recommend it to anyone. The final note on this To Glimpse experience from me to you is,
I would definitely recommend it to anybody who wants to experience daily life abroad. It's such an amazing experience to be in somebody's home. I have to honestly say, I learned the most about India by staying with local people and letting them tell me about their daily life. And I kind of feel the same way here in Serbia as well, because obviously when I was staying with my parents before, we have our own family rituals and things that we know about each other, but this was a completely new experience for me, even though I am born in this city. And now that I've given you that review, it was also time to visit my family. Made it to my aunt's place. So this is my mom's sister.
Da, ja sam Vesna. My name is Vesna.
Hello, auntie.
Hello.
So happy to be here again after such a long time. And it's the first time I'm meeting my nephew. Kako se zoveš?
Ivan.
Ivan! His baby! He's the same name as me! He's such a cutie and he's so happy with his tablet playing a game. Mwah. Cutie pie. And we have this one over here. So actually, they have three cats, which they adopted last year. And we have another cat over here. And another one over here. And this one is a cutie. Cutie, Floof. Her nickname is Floof. Look at her. Well, now you also know why she's called Floof. She loves to cuddle. Yeah. My aunt also cooked a phenomenal meal. She's one of the best cooks I know. Like, seriously. Kiflice. Kiflice. Teta Vesna. We need to have those. So those are like the little breads. She makes the best one with the walnuts.
Of course.
And we have a dessert, but it's getting upgraded. So this is the pita with pumpkin. And my cousin, who you'll meet later because she's not ready for the camera right now, she is making the ultimate food porn. Look at this beauty. Ooh. Ooh. Oh my gosh. This is life. We got even more yumminess. So these are freeze-dried raspberries. Look at that color. So this is the finished version with added hazelnuts. And this one doesn't know how to stop because we're adding ice cream to this as well. My goodness.
Vanilla.
What is this? I told her she needs to come to India. I need to feed her. Life.
Final touch.
It looks amazing. And this is my niece. Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Mina.
Mina. Hello. Beautiful.
This is so good. I'm completely unprepared for this.
Beauty.
So.
That's okay.
Yeah.
That's totally okay.
I don't even know what
you
to
look
say.
Fabulous anyway.
Same.
I honestly can't even describe how cute my nephew is. He's like such an amazing, good little boy, and I hope I get to spend more time with him while I'm here. I also visited another aunt of mine. I am getting fluffier and more soft every single day while staying here, but I don't mind it for one bit because I'm getting so much peace and comfort, you know, just being with my family, being with Auntie Lola. That's why I also decided to stay here and spend more time with her. This may sound super mushy, but honestly, it's true. So I have to tell you, please bear with me. The most important thing you ever will have in your life is the relationships with the people who you love. There's nothing that can top that. I've witnessed the most beautiful sunrises and sunsets in the most beautiful places all over the world. But if you don't have people who you love to share those experiences with, it's actually quite depressing. That's my conclusion of this year. For now, I already want to wish you a very, very Merry Christmas. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, because I am very grateful to have you here, and I hope to see you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.